Now that's a contract. But we still don't have a database. Our database class will extend an Android class, SQLiteOpenHelper. SQLiteOpenHelper contains cool stuff to help us handle database versioning. As we make changes to our database in the future, it will help us modify our tables. For many apps, being able to upgrade to a new version without data loss is critical. Let's create a WeatherDB helper class within the data package and have it extend SQLiteOpenHelper. We can add the required methods by hitting Ctrl-I, and we can override the constructor by hitting Ctrl-O. So now we can hard code these variables to the constructor, hard coding name to database name, our factory to null, and our version to database version. Now you'll note I have made the database name public, and that's because we're going to use it in our tests in the future. Now you see we've got an onCreate and an onUpgrade method. In the onCreate method, we're going to start by creating a string to build the weather entry table using data defined within the weather entry contract. Now I'm just going to add this comment so you know where to go back and add the location entry stuff later. Since weather entry depends on location entry, I would normally write location entry first, but weather entry is pretty complicated, so I'd rather explain what we've done and leave location entry up to you. We're going to use raw SQL for our create table query, beginning with the table name from our contract. At this point, it's helpful to import weather_contract.location_entry and weather entry. It makes our query so much easier to read. We'll start with our ID field, which we'll set as our primary key and an auto increment field. Note that integer is actually a signed value up to 8 bytes long in SQLite. Using the auto increment feature doesn't do precisely what one might think. Setting up the ID as an integer primary key actually makes the value unique whenever you do an insert, but it may not always increment. It may reuse existing ID values if the records have been deleted. What auto-increment is really useful for is if you are synchronizing data two ways with the server. But we'll take advantage of it here because it makes data from our query sort a bit more naturally because we insert them in the right order coming from the server. In general, we're using constraints on fields, in this case not null. We do this because it allows the database to do much of our parameter validation for us. The tricky part about doing it this way is that we don't get useful errors when these constraints fail, so it can be challenging to debug. We're using a human-readable string for the date. There's no strong reason for or against this choice. We wanted to normalize the date to simplify our queries, and human readability simplifies debugging. The date comes from OpenWeather in Unix timestamp format with some time information that we need to get rid of. I'm not going to cover every field. Real means floating point in SQL. It would have been fine to have used integer with fixed point math as well, and some would argue that this would be faster, but real is more straightforward since we're storing floating point values. Now for the fun stuff. We're going to set up the loc key as a foreign key to the location entry table that you will be building. This causes SQLite to enforce the relationship between the tables. We cannot insert a weather entry when there is no corresponding location entry. And we cannot delete a location entry if there are still weather entries that depend on it. Cool stuff, right? One last constraint. Our date text plus location must be unique. On conflict, replace the data. This allows us to insert new data from the OpenWeather API easily, preserving existing keys and updating the values if the forecast changes.